गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, सॉरी अबाउट द ग्लिचेस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक डॉक्टर उमेश कपिल एंड प्रोफेसर सरीन गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी दैट वी शुड ऑर्गेनाइज अ जॉइंट वेबिनार विद इक्वल पार्टनर ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ नॉन अल्कोहलिक फैटी लिवर डिजीज. एज now everyone knows my specialty is not so good about the liver disorders and then of course in the population based study we are just in my whole of the career I have been focusing on hepatitis of halothane hepatitis and of course the jaundice, post operative jaundice. So but as we all know that liver is the largest sieve of the human body, in which and it is a part of a portal system. So where the mesenteric circulation, all the toxins and virus, bacteria, whatever comes into the mesenteric circulation goes through liver, and that is the first encounter in the body. But liver is just not a sieve, but is an organ of endocrine and metabolic functions. So I just thought I will talk about only on these four headings. The outline remains a little introduction, and it's a relationship with the multi-system disease, and of course now it is involving the children, and of the lifestyle is and the eating habits are the most important cause for this. So how to change it? Now, in the time of everyone talking about coronavirus and the pandemic, this topic, I am very happy that Dr. Sareen is taking up this topic in continuum, which is a for which not many people are a taker to talk about, but stands. A morbidity in the society, and I'm sure after some time we might also know about the researches of coronavirus disease affecting liver, how it affects liver also. But today's topic, what is that? The most common thing I think whenever I talk to the some of the relatives, etc., very commonly they come that I am having a fatty liver diagnosed during their routine visits for the some GI upset or some mild pain kind of a situation. And so it is a topic must be taken up by some group, and ILBS is has very rightly pointed out that we must address this as a national endemic with the incidence 5 to 10%, and it comes as a non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. So as we all know, the liver has a fat content all the and it may have some inflammatory changes, as we said, that depending upon our environment and the eating of the water content of our infectivity of the water and the cooked food, etc., they all can contribute to some extent inflammation. And usually the non-alcoholic fatty liver may not progress but for small morbidity. But if it goes into what is called the steatohepatitis, then of course it becomes a progressive kind of a disease, which may lead to cirrhosis and even has been correlated with the liver cancer. Now, if you go on a world map, then it is not simply a disease of countries who are rich and they have a high calorie content eating, but it's markedly prevalent in Asian countries. And the highest incidence, 31.8%. For India, the data is not very concrete, but the incidence again has been reported in various studies from 3 to 32%, 9 to 32% range. So it is a disease which is commonly prevalent in the society. Particularly what I feel in the south, in Telugu, this Andhra Pradesh, the eating habits are so that I have seen a lot of obesity component here. And I'm sure if all are investigated, significantly high incidence of fatty liver we might see here. So this certainly needs attention, and that too in a continuum manner rather than a sporadic event. So such seminars will certainly enlighten all of us towards a disease which is in a very subtle manner affecting the population. So now type 2 diabetes I can say the type 2 diabetes and non-alcoholic fatty liver disease go and hand in gloves. They promote each other, and then it also causes, suppose a person is having a fatty liver, then he will have a tendency of fat accumulation in all other body organs also. So it may promote it may be a part of multi-systemic disorders present in any particular person. And it's a progression towards cirrhosis, again makes things to liver transplant may become the only answer at the end of the, if it converts into cirrhosis. And so such patients are bound to develop the chronic kidney disease, cardiovascular disease, because atherosclerotic changes will be there. So heart will also be affected. So it is a kind of a go around involving all the organs. And of course, endocrine system is, it may be a part of a polycystic ovarian disease also, and some other endocrine diseases. So it does require attention in our national, the policy, which Dr. Sareen has rightly brought in the front. And so the NASH can lead to cardiac deaths also. So that is just to show this slide, and 40 to 45% of total deaths with histologically confirmed NAFLD have demonstrated cardiovascular disease. So they are strongly associated and perpetuate each other along with subclinical atherosclerosis. And it can be, it has also been described as a metabolic syndrome. And it is a lifestyle disorder. In my opinion, this becomes a lifestyle disorder in which high calorie eating and no activity or physical activity are the basic reason. So this just to show that how the These things are perpetuating to insulin resistance, then metabolic syndrome, then diabetes mellitus, and then again perpetuating to the non-alcoholic fatty liver. In children also, now it is becoming, it has started showing up that the disease with the metabolic features, and it's all because of over fat, this eating habits which are changing, and this children are not getting that adequate exercise, and the situation is even bad nowadays because everyone is going for isolation, and they are not even going to schools. So these things make them the disease has started showing up in children also, and it needs attention. Certainly attention is required that how the eating habits of the children can be modified, and their playful activities should be increased rather than sitting on the mobiles and this TV and computer games, etc. So that needs to be addressed at a national level. So when identifying patient with advanced fibrosis, as the this diagnostic part, I don't think I have to speak much about it, because it will be elaborated by experts. So currently there is no approved drugs for the treatment, and no specific therapy can firmly be recommended for that. And the lifestyle activity, increase activity, and diet habits remain the crux for the treatment this this non-alcoholic fatty liver disease management. So energy should be restricted, and then macronutrient low to moderate fat, fructose intake, avoid fructose containing food and drink, and then coffee consumption, etc., should be made to the minimum. And of course alcohol intake may not may be another factor which may further affect the liver in presence of fatty liver disease. So we have to increase our physical activity. So just to end the talk, our take home messages that metabolic liver disease increase tremendously and will become a main cause for morbidity mortality if not addressed. Fibrosis is considered the key mechanism of its poor prognosis if it leads to, and it is a part of multi-system disease as it and affects all the age group of the population. Effective lifestyle changes can only improve the liver function and liver histology, and screening tests have to be done as time to time. And then if it is detected early, then remedial measures can be suggested by all the hepatologists and the physicians. So I thank you very much for giving this opportunity.